gonna do a little walk on the treadmill, and that's kind of about it this morning because I'm gonna be just kind of sitting all day. Also, I switch out my Apple Watch band, like, for workouts, and as I was switching it out, apparently I hit the wrong button, and I just called 911, and he answered, and I had to tell him that my watch called him. Off to a great start today. That was great, calling 911 accidentally this morning. I don't know what happened. I was switching out my watch band and then I called it. So I am getting ready for work and currently debating whether or not I can pull off wearing leggings to work with over the knee boots and a long top. I think I might be able to. I just want to be like comfy on my, like, cause I'm going to be in this outfit all day. So I also thought I'd give you another public speaking tip. Something that really works for me. So I used to speak, and you probably noticed this in some of my videos, if not all, that I speak really quickly. So I'd also like to start off, which I should have said this before, and I will when I do my series, I was petrified of speaking in public, like couldn't function. I remember high school speech class being just like, how quickly can I read whatever is on this note card so I can just be done? No one's ever probably spoken that quickly before. So I was just so scared. I was scared up until I'd say probably about like 8 years ago. So something that helps me, I'll get to it, when I'm speaking quickly is that, like, I know it feels awkward to pause like that, but you need to give your audience time to understand what you're saying. If you're speaking too quickly, they can't follow along. That information is new to them. It's not new to you. So you have to speak as though they've never heard it before because they've never heard it before. So something that helps me is keeping that in mind, but also thinking about one phrase to one person. Now, you don't even have to be in a group of people. I was coaching a colleague the other day, you know, she has two monitors. I'm like, speak to each monitor. So what that means is, you know, if you're in a room, so maybe it's a boardroom, maybe it's just a group of people, it's a regular team meeting, and you wanna look at one person and say, like, okay, how was your day today? My day was really good. So next on the agenda, we're gonna talk about our plan for this month. And you don't have to go like this. You can look here, then look to the person next to them, look back at that person, whatever it is. Or look at a chair, because people don't really know either. So one phrase, one person, it will help slow your pace. I promise you, you just have to keep it in mind. Anytime you find yourself like speaking very quickly, just think about it. And after time, it'll just be how you speak. And it's pretty cool. So there's your public speaking tip this morning. I'm gonna put on my makeup and watch the Today Show and finish packing. I just have to kind of put everything into the actual luggage. And Vegas. All right, it's time to pack. I have not much, many, I'm just gonna go and show you what I'm doing. So I like to put brushes in the grooves and anything like this in the grooves of the suitcase. So that's what I do here. And I have a big curling iron, which actually, move this to there. This to there. There we go. So it makes up the space there. And then I'm gonna go ahead and put the rest of the stuff in. Packing cube one, packing cube two. I'll close this up. Oh, actually, you know what? I'm gonna throw, oh, that's gonna work. We shall see. Now on this side, I get my sneaks in there. They always fit right there, it's perfect. This is a little high today. Those are flat, just slide them underneath. And now we have to get all this other stuff in. I might not bring that purse. So you can see stuff bulging out of my luggage. I had to sit on it. Anyways, I am headed to work, but I wanted to have like a work appropriate outfit that's also comfortable for travel. By the way, not easy to figure out, and my hair is not doing what I want it to do. So I have my Dudley Stevens black fleece on, a long t-shirt underneath, and then I have these velour Spanx leggings that I forgot I had. I've had them for years. I probably only worn them a handful of times, if that. And then my Stuart Weitzman boots. So hopefully I won't have to take these off through TSA. I have pre-check, but sometimes boots have, hopefully there's no metal because that'll take a minute. So this is my look. I'm gonna throw on a leather coat and a leopard print scarf, and I'm gonna be sweating. So I'm just making a lot of noise. I was going to take an Uber. It is $15 and it's to go 1.1 miles. So I'm gonna brave the L and hope that people don't hate me because I have luggage, because that's what happens. I feel like I've already had a whole day. Whew. This cold air actually feels good for a minute. I'm like sweating under all my layers. All right, I don't wanna fall, so I will chat with you later. L elevators are the smelliest, and I'm about to get one. I hope it comes here soon. But where is it? So for some reason, people pee in them. Here we go, slowly coming. That was odd. It was like a street fair inside there. I haven't walked through there in a while, so maybe that's like a thing. I'm sure people I know who work in there will tell me in the comments. All right, check out these dolls. Like Mr. Potato Head is there. Didn't take too long on the blue line. If you ever come to Chicago and you land around rush hour, just take the blue line. Or if you need it, so much quicker and cheaper. Made it through security in like not even 2 minutes. I have about a half hour before I board my flight, which isn't too much time, but I'm gonna grab some food so I don't have to eat on the plane. I got McDonald's, and I get McDonald's breakfast. Sort of. I got an egg McMuffin and fries. It's super healthy. But it's the only thing that kind of sounded good to me. Everything else looked kind of gross. I know you probably think McDonald's is gross, but whatever. When I'm at the airport, it's an exception I make. Like, what happened to this? Also, Xfinity has this set up here at the airport. And they're running Hallmark movies. Like, I could sit here all day and just watch. It'd be even better if they could Bluetooth it into my AirPods here. Vegas. One random fun, not so fun fact is one time I was here and my flight was delayed 11 hours. I did leave the airport, but I was here for quite some time. And every time I come back, it just reminds me of the time I was here for that long. there are like a lot of people in the Uber and Lyft line. Also, the lighting's really good right here. I'm gonna hop in an Uber. I'm a little tired. I'm gonna figure it out. Giada, she always says words weird, and this shirt has everything on it.